always serving a fresh cup of daily inspiration, Deanna Hobbs.
In today's inspiration, we'll discuss what to do when God doesn't do it your way. There are seasons when we have an expectation of how God should move, of how he should answer us, of how he should perform our miracle, of how our breakthrough should manifest. But as you know, God's ways are not our ways. They are better. His plan is far superior to anything you could imagine or ask for. So today, be encouraged. He might not do it your way, but he's going to do it the best way and cause all things to work together for your good. Welcome to this, your Friday, July 13th, 2018 edition of your Daily Cup of Inspiration podcast. My name is Deanna Hobbs, founder of Empowering Everyday Women Ministries, a 501c3 nonprofit organization that distributes free resources worldwide to help you grow in your faith and become everything God has destined you to be. I bring you warmest greetings live from Empowering Everyday Women Ministry Studios in the city of Buffalo, New York. It is currently 69 degrees in the Queen City. I received such an awesome praise report saying I wanted to thank you so much for your prayers for a job. I've landed a full-time job and I'm so excited. I start Monday. Thank you for your faithfulness to your Daily Cup of Inspiration. I have been following since the beginning and the devotions and podcast touch me daily. It is my honor to pray and stand in faith with you, and I'm believing God to move on your behalf, whatever it is that you are trusting him for. Our Daily Cup community is strong and God is having his way. Every single podcast you hear, it's available for you as a free resource. Stream it, download it on iTunes, Google Play, Stitcher.com, yourdailycupofinspiration.com, player.fm on my YouTube channel under my name, Deanna Hobbs, DIANNA HOBBS. When you click that red subscribe button and turn on your notifications, every time a podcast is uploaded, you will be among the first to know. Make sure you also follow me online, Twitter at Team Deanna Hobbs, Facebook at Deanna.Hobbs, and Instagram at I Am Deanna Hobbs. Let's begin with a prayer this morning. God, our Father, we love you. Thank you for bringing us through this week. We realize that without you, we can do nothing. This individual that you've sent to this podcast needs desperately to hear from you. And I know you are going to speak with clarity, authority, and the anointing that will be life transforming for them. In Jesus' name, amen. Daily Cup family, I woke up this morning with God's people just so heavily on my heart. I was talking a little bit about prayer requests during the introductory comments today, and we receive requests from all over the world, and we bombard heaven asking God to intervene, make a way, reverse negative outcomes, and move in your favor. In addition to the usual prayer requests, I received an urgent message that a young woman locally has received a diagnosis from her doctor saying there's no hope for her condition. And so her family is holding a special prayer and desires that I come and join in. Initially, I was so excited to come, and then I found out that I will not be in the city at that specific date and time, and there's no way I can make it there. The human side of me felt sad that I can't go. Especially because I know the power of prayer, gathering together and touching and agreeing. After all, God healed my body at a prayer service. But before I could let the burden of what I could not do weigh me down, God reminded me that the power doesn't belong to us. His ability to heal is not based upon my ability to show up physically. And whether or not I can be there in person, his spirit is there. Amen. Sometimes we get caught up in wanting to do things a certain way and having our own expectations for how we want God to move, but his ways are not our ways. They are better. This reminds me of a fundamental lesson from 2 Kings 5, one of my favorite Bible stories about Naaman. Naaman was a leprous military commander for the Syrian army. The Aramaeans had carried out a raid against Israel and won, taking people captive and dragging them by force into a foreign land. But God still had a purpose for Naaman's life, to show him that he was the true and living God. Naaman was a proud man. He was a powerful man, but God did not heal Naaman the way he would have preferred. Before he could obtain his healing, he had to go and dip himself in the dirty Jordan River 7 times as the prophet Elisha commanded. This made Naaman so angry, he felt too important to do something that menial. He didn't like the process God was using to loose him from the bondage of illness. Naaman wanted the prophet to come outside and make some grand gesture, but that wasn't God's will. Have you ever gone through a Jordan River season where God took you through a difficult process that you felt was unfair, unwarranted, undesirable, or even beneath you? If so, that means he was humbling you and working anything out of you that might hinder you from bearing righteous fruit and receiving all he has for you. In 2 Kings 5, we learn that once Naaman did what God used Elisha, a true vessel of the Lord, to instruct him to do, every trace of that detestable disease was gone. In a moment, he got his miracle. Breakthrough happened. The hand of the Lord moved in his favor. I find it interesting that Naaman's name is derived from the Hebrew word na'im, which actually means to be delightful, pleasant, beautiful. It implies that he is gracious or even well-formed. Wow. Before being healed, Naaman's name didn't seem befitting of this horrible affliction. People who had leprosy were regarded as unclean, anything but well-formed, as Naaman's name denoted. But given the significance of names in scripture and the seemingly contradictory name of Naaman due to his physical condition, we recognize God's hand all over his life. The Lord already knew of Naaman's destiny. It was imprinted in his name before it was ever reflected in his circumstances. The same is true for you. God knows that where you are now is not the end of your story. Greater is coming if you submit to his plan. You, just like Naaman, will most certainly tap into God's miraculous power and be victorious in your life if you're willing to submit to your process. But be warned, your process at times will lead you through a dark valley. This message today is for somebody who thought God was going to do it one way. He's going to do it another. It's going to be better than anything you could ever imagine. I know these deep valleys and these low places are not what you saw for yourself. You thought the favor of God might help you skip over some Jordan River experiences. Why did you have to sink so low? Why did you have to hurt so badly? Why did you have to go through such terrible struggles? Why was your childhood so difficult? Why do you battle in your emotions? Why can't your marriage be easier? Why can't your job be better? Why can't God just answer the prayer? Why can't God just open the door? Why won't he just save your loved one? Why won't he restore you? Why? Instead of trying to figure God out and getting upset because it's not going your way, trust his way. If we learn anything from Naaman, we learn that what looks like the worst method turns out to be the best thing for us. He didn't like the way God did it, but the result was amazing. I know that you don't like tests. It would be preferable for God to use another method to get you to where he wants you to go. But trust him. When you're crying, trust him. When you feel broken, trust him. When you're upset, trust him. When you're sick and tired of being sick and tired, trust him. He loves you with a perfect love. Don't throw away your faith. Don't give up. He is up to something. Hebrews 10 and 35 through 36 in the New International Version, which is what I'm stirring into your cup of inspiration, says, "So do not throw away your confidence. It will be richly rewarded. You need to persevere so that when you have done the will of God, you will receive what he has promised." As you drink down the contents of your cup, I want to leave that reminder with you that you cannot throw away your confidence just because God doesn't do it your way. If you keep persevering, if you keep trusting him, if you keep pushing past your doubts, God will do exactly what he said. So be encouraged to keep running this race. It's not over yet. You may not like the rough terrain you have to tread, but know that God is with you, leading you every step of the way. Your Jordan River isn't pleasant, but when you come out of it, you will see the word of God fulfilled. His way, though not always the most comfortable way, way is the best way. Believe His promises and rest in Him. Now let's pray. God, I pray for this, my sister, this, my brother. They don't have a pedestal tall enough to see over this mountain of trouble that makes deliverance look impossible. And they don't know where this path leads. Though their flesh cries out for a different solution, I pray that you will give them the power, the humility, the strength to say yes to your will, even when it hurts, knowing that though it might be uncomfortable, you will cause all things to work together. Together for their good and for your glory. In Jesus' name, thank you, Lord. Amen.
Your Daily Cup of Inspiration podcast has been brought to you by Empowering Everyday Women Ministries, where we help fuel your faith every day. For more information, log on to www.deannahobbs.com.